Hello guys, I'm Yadgir Reddy and welcome to the series of Selenium interview questions. So generally, when you go to any automation interview based on Selenium, the interviewer will start asking you questions about Selenium, Java and all, right? So sometimes he will ask you only theoretical questions and sometimes he might ask you to write a program also. So maybe he will ask you to write a simple Selenium script, which includes four steps. Open the Chrome browser, navigate to Google homepage, then print the title in the console, and close the browser. Okay, so this is what he will ask you to write. So then what you will do, you will start writing the program, right? So you will write something like this. So the next question the interviewer will ask you is, please explain this line. So that is what interviewer will ask you. So now what you need to answer? If he asks you to explain this line, what you need to answer? So before we look at the answer, first let us understand this line, okay? So let me break this line into four pieces. So this is one piece, and this is one, and this is one, and this is one. Okay. So here, WebDriver is an interface. So when you mouse over on this, you can see here it says I. So this is an interface. Okay. And next, driver. This driver is a local variable. And next we have equal. Equal is an assigning operator. So next one is new keyword. So generally in Java, we use new keyword to create an object, right? So if you want to create an object for any class, we use the new keyword. So that is about new keyword. Then ChromeDriver. So basically this is a constructor. So generally we have a rule in the Java, right? The constructor name and the class name should be same. I mean, whatever the class name is there, with the class name, we are going to define the constructor, right? If you are invoking this ChromeDriver constructor, that means this constructor is coming from the ChromeDriver class. So you need to understand that. So now we are calling constructor here. Okay. So now if you go from right hand side to left hand side, we are creating a object for the ChromeDriver class by calling this ChromeDriver constructor. Okay. The default constructor, right? So what this will do, this will open the Chrome browser. So after opening the Chrome browser, we want to perform some actions on the browser, right? So if you want to perform any action on the browser, first we should have that instance, the browser instance stored in some variable. Then only you can use that variable and perform the actions, right? So that is the reason we are storing this ChromeDriver instance into one driver variable. Okay. So in Java, if you want to define a variable, we need to define the data type also, right? So for example, if I write something like this, a equal 5, so it will throw me an error. Why? Because you are doing the initialization, but you are not defining the variable, right? So this A is a variable. I know that. But how Java knows that this A is a variable and what type of data it can hold? So further, first you need to define what kind of data it can store, right? So that is the data type. So now we are saying A is a variable which holds the integer type of information. Okay. So the similar way, we need to define this driver also. What kind of information this can store. So here we are saying WebDriver. So basically, if you are creating an object for ChromeDriver and storing it in one variable, then that variable should actually store a ChromeDriver type of data, right? So here you are assigning the integer, so you are giving integer as a data type, right? So the similar way, if you are creating the object for new ChromeDriver, I mean this ChromeDriver, then your data type also should be a ChromeDriver, right? But we are writing this one. That is because this ChromeDriver is implementing WebDriver interface. If you look at this diagram, you will understand. So the WebDriver is an interface and this interface will have some unimplemented methods, right? So something like this. You may have a get method, get title, close, quit, like this. You have some unimplemented methods. So those methods are implemented in remote WebDriver class. This ChromeDriver, Firefox driver, Internet Explorer driver, Opera, Edge driver, these all are classes only, okay? So these classes extend remote WebDriver class. That means these classes also have the implementation of WebDriver interface, right? So that is the reason when you are creating the object, you are giving at the interface level, okay? You can define ChromeDriver also here, or you can define what kind of interface it is. So if the ChromeDriver is implemented by some interface, then you can define that interface also here, okay? So here basically we are invoking the default ChromeDriver. That means the default settings of Chrome browser will be invoked. So if you want to change any settings or anything, you can use the desired capabilities or Chrome options, and you can pass that desired capabilities or Chrome options here. Then with the user-defined settings, the Chrome browser will be invoked. But here, the default Chrome browser is invoking. Okay. So for this question, what is the meaning of this line? You should answer like, here we are creating a ChromeDriver instance and storing it in a variable called driver, which is of type WebDriver interface. Okay. So this is what you need to answer. So I hope you got the idea, right? What exactly this line is. So that is about this video, guys. I hope you enjoy this video. If you like the video, please hit the like button and also share this video with your friends. So if you have any doubts on this topic, please comment in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.